Welcome back to Kedstart. We've had such an insightful and intensive discussion with Senate President Juan Miguel Zubiri on charter change, where he stands with CONCON. Now let's move on to how he sees a way, in a way, to really address problems, to prioritize on actually addressing problems that the Philippines is facing. So recently he proposed a minimum wage hike of 150 pesos for all private workers. So Senate President Miguel Zubiri, how can you actually mandate, and is it actually wise to order private companies to do that? I mean, in the United States, you have Joe Biden ordering the biggest federal increase with salaries for government workers. But can you really legislate salaries for private workers, considering we have 90% of the businesses in the Philippines are MSMEs?
Well, Karen, you know, in the United States, looking at the United States model, they've increased in the last 10 years their minimum wage per hour. It used to be like $6 an hour. Now it's about $10 to $11 per hour, depending on the state. So, napakalaki ng increase nila in the last decade. Ang atin kaya, napakabagal, hindi gumagalaw. And we all know, because of the high cost of inflation, napakamahal ng bilihin. Ang masama dito, Karen, to be honest, many products, including agricultural products, nakatikim na yan ng mataas na prices, and therefore, many of them are hesitant to bring these prices down, unless the president has a policy of importing everything, which of course will kill the agri-industry. So, what do we need to do? Kailangan natin bigyan ang ating manggagawa ng tinatawag natin living wage. Hindi naman minimum wage, because the minimum wage is not a living wage. We also have to share. We have to share. I think we have to share the blessings, Karen. Every time I watch The World Tonight, I watch it every 9 o'clock. And then if I miss it, I watch it at 12 midnight. I always look at the business side. I always look at the companies coming back from pandemic pandemic levels. Talagang they go back to the black. They're making a lot of money. There's an increase in income, particularly the oil companies and all the other companies that were doing poorly during the pandemic. Now, kaya ng akin lang, share naman natin. Share lang. Let's share to our people. I personally, you know, Karen, I'm not only a public servant, but I'm also a businessman. I do industrialize. We also have, I'm also a small power producer. I have renewable energy. We're doing hydro and all. All my employees that are minimum wage earners, they earn, I give them more than minimum wage. Okay. So whatever minimum wage is, I give them more. I give them more, a certain percentage more. I give them 15 months pay. So they get 13 months plus 2 years, 2 months bonus. So I'm an MSME, but my point is, tuwan-tuwa yung mga workers ko. I did it the same in the Senate. I was bashed in the Senate. I gave an inflation bonus, which is basically 130 pesos a day for the whole year. And I was bashed. Everybody was saying, sana all. Okay, sa ating mga kababayan na nagsasabing sana all, ito na to. Ito na. We'll try to pass a 150 peso legislated wage increase because we need to come up with an amount where our people are comfortable. Na talagang hindi po sila hirap na hirap at hindi po sila umiiyak na wala po sila pambayad sa gastusin na kanilang mga tahanan.
All right. And irony of this is, of course, in the lower house, it wasn't the majority who suggested an increase across the board. It was the Makabayan bloc, right? So that's the irony here, is the majority in the Senate, well, coming from the Senate president himself, in effect, in a way, siding with the minority in the lower house. So I want to ask you, the ECOP says two things, so you can answer directly. They say if you raise the minimum wage further, only two things will happen. Small businesses will either cut the number of employees or they will raise the prices of their products. They claim that raising the minimum wage will only benefit 10% of the total number of workers in the Philippines to the detriment of the remaining 90%. So what do you think of that statement?
Well, why do you think there's a diaspora of Filipinos from the Philippines? Maalis sila. I saw a video online sa Facebook. I just happened to chance upon it. And the title nun, why Filipinos are leaving their own country. Number one, ini-interview sila sa lahat ng mga bansa na pinupuntahan nila. Napakababa ng minimum wage, napakababa ng sweldo ng ating bansa. That's the whole truth. That's why we have how many million Filipinos? 12 million Filipinos abroad. It's because we don't pay the right or at least decent wages here in the Philippines. We have to address that, Karen. If we don't address that, we will have a brain drain. Mawawalan tayo ng workers. Tara, anong gusto nila? Pag-graduate ng college, gusto nila mag-abroad ka agad. Yung makakuha lang ng passport na hindi naman nakagraduate ng college, gusto mag-abroad ka agad. Bakit? Kung dito sila magtrabaho sa ating bansa, ang matatanggap nila ay, imagine, $10 a day, which is $10 an hour in the United States. Sa United States, Estados Unidos, $10 an hour. Ang akin dyan, eventually, mawawalan din tayo ng manggagawa. I'm also asking the ECO, what is your solution? We're losing our workers. They're going abroad. They'd rather go abroad because nobody wants to share their blessings. Nobody. So, okay. I mean, your husband, DJ, works for Aboitiz. I know they can afford. They can afford this. Many other companies, the Aboitizes, the Lushotans, the Gokong Ways, all the major players can afford this. I'm sure they can afford this because I've seen their bottom line every time I watch the news.
Yeah, so that's ECOP's argument that only 10% can afford this. The MSMEs will be affected. But okay, let's move on because you make a good argument there. Is in effect with 500 plus 150, it evens out to something like 750. Tama po ba? That's your calculation, no?
Opo.
No, para magiging 750 a day ang minimum wage, which becomes a decent living wage. So yes. My question now is political. This is where horse trading begins in some way, right? You may have the support of your colleagues with your bill, but then in the lower house, the majority isn't actually touching that yet. So what happens now for this to become law? You would need your colleagues in the lower house. And what if they ask, look, Senate President, we're asking you to at least even consider cha-cha before we even touch the increase in minimum wage. So paano to ngayon, Senate
President? At kukulit na nga nila sa amin sa Maharlika pa lang. Hindi pa namin natatakal yung Maharlika. Yeah. So maybe we should tackle Maharlika first before we tackle about the cha-cha. Again, no, I'm going into the reasons why we're doing this. We want to help uplift our people's lives. You want to pass Maharlika? Okay, why? Because you want to invest in strategic industries? Okay, and be able to help make income, additional income for the country. But bottom line, it's to help our country move up, no? From the economic rut that we came in from the pandemic. And so that's the bottom line. We have to work together. The House of Representatives, Speaker Martin is a dear friend of mine. I, whenever we call each other brothers. Brother Martin.
But then he hasn't called you yet? The speaker hasn't called you yet when it comes
No, because he knows my position already. I had this discussion with the president and Speaker Martin privately in the home of the president in Malacañang. And the president himself said, oo nga Martin, hindi ko priority ito. Then I'm busy going around selling the country and being able to fix the problems of the country. So right there and then I heard the president tell him that, you know, this maguluyan, and because of that, and he's a senator. He was a former congressman. He was a former senator. He's seen these charter change wars unfold, and it can be very divisive. It can be very divisive as an issue. So, nakita ko po yung stand ni Presidente doon, and I told the president, and I told Speaker Martin at that time, this can be very divisive. I don't have the numbers in the Senate. Can we just focus on the bills at hand, the LEDAC priorities, allow me to finish these LEDAC priorities, including Maharlika, so we can discuss it and debate on it on the floor. So they know my position on that. That's why, in fairness to my dear friend Martin, Speaker Martin, hindi niya siguro ako kinukulit na araw-araw. It's mostly the other congressmen. Pero ang punto ko dyan is, we're not ignoring them. Nandyan si Senator Padilla, he's going around doing his listening tour. He'll come up with his committee report. The thing there is, will he be able to get enough signatures to be able to tackle the committee report in plenary? So the process is ongoing in the Senate, and we're not ignoring our House of Representatives' counterparts. But at this point in time, allow me to pass the LEDAC-approved measures that will be able to help our people. So, when it comes to that, Karen, let's say pinasa namin yung legislative wage hike in the Senate at hingi ng horse trading or some sort of compromise, I leave it at that. I tell them, you know, this is good for the country. I leave it to the House of Representatives on how they feel about this issue. But what's important in the end, at the end of the day, Karen, alam mo, lalo na sa mga probinsya, yung minimum wage sila doon 300 pesos, Karen, na 300 pesos. What can you buy with 300 pesos? Inflation has not just reached Metro Manila. Inflation has reached Northern Mindanao. Inflation has reached Central Visayas. Inflation has reached everywhere. And I think we have to address that problem of inflation by also increasing. You know, I put 150 as the number. We can increase or decrease. We can make it 100 pesos. But the ECOP and all the business organizations should know that the people are suffering. They should talk to their workers. Talk to your workers and ask them, kaya nyo ba to na ganito yung presyo, yung sahod?
But there must be a science.
If they increase their salaries, they're going to have a more productive workforce.
But there must be, just quickly, there must be a science to the 750 number. Because even if you presented it differently from the Makabayan block, it all ends up with 750 a day.
There will be a price distortion, Karen. Mine is different from the Makabayan block. Because the Makabayan block wants 750 all across the board. Hindi naman pwedeng ganun sa mga areas na kung saan 300 pesos yung minimum wage, gagawin mo 750. Totoong sinabi ng ECOP, magkakagulo dyan. I mean, these businesses cannot pay double their wages of what they're paying now. No, they can't absorb that. Mine is 150 across the board. So basically, if it does 300 pesos in, let's say, in Samar or Northern Cebu, it will become 450. Yeah, I think what they need is that additional cushion. So they can pay their bills, they can buy food for their children, they can, you know, nagtaas ang presyo ng bilihin, tumaas din ang presyo ng basic utilities. So at least it's a cushion.
Okay, so Senate President, last question on that particular issue. Where are you now with this particular bill?
We just filed the measure. It will go to the committee of Senator Jingo Estrada. And historically, I've been filing this, Karen, for a while back now. I filed this in Congress. I filed this also in the Senate in my first term. And I'm also one of the proponents of yung na-veto ni President Duterte, which is on job security. Security of Tenure Act. And you know, we passed that in the Senate, the Security of Tenure Act. And that was a very difficult thing to pass. It was vetoed by then President Duterte, unfortunately. So I really believe to have a strong economy, you have to have a strong and happy workforce, Karen.
All right. On that note, Senate President Juan Miguel Zubiri, I want to thank you for joining me today. This was an insightful, extensive interview. Thank you so much, sir. You have a good
day. I'm happy to be here, Karen. And God bless you and God bless your viewers. Mabuhay pong ating bansa.
All right.